So even though you've got a syllabus, it's really useful to write learning objectives. And writing those objectives solves some problems in education, some really common problems. So I asked some experts in education to tell us about some of the problems that learning objectives help solve.
My name is Sarah Wise, and I'm a former high school teacher, and currently I coach faculty in biology on their classes and on their curricula. When developing courses for the first time, sometimes it feels overwhelming to figure out what are you going to talk about, how are you going to fill the time, what is the most important things to focus on. Starting with their big ideas for learning goals and then figuring out how to meet each of those learning goals step by step can really help them be confident that their course is going to turn out the way that they had wanted.
I'm Jenny Knight, and I teach biology to freshmen and other levels of students as well. And I also run faculty workshops to help faculty learn about teaching or how to improve their teaching. So faculty are excited about the content they teach, and they usually like all the topics that they are in front of them on their syllabus. And they don't really like the idea of dropping content. But we also know from years of research and personal experience that covering a whole bunch of different topics very superficially doesn't really help the students learn those topics. It just gives them a really quick glimpse of the field, and they probably go away really remembering very little about it. The way learning objectives can help with that solves a problem of too much breadth and not enough depth. So I think it helps faculty to narrow their scope and go deeper rather than broader.
Often on faculty evaluation, students complain that exams don't reflect the content of the material they saw in class. They think that might be unfair. What I found is that when instructors develop their learning goals and write their exams to meet those learning goals, students end up much happier because the course is aligned from beginning to end.
When a student looks at a syllabus for their class, they might just see a list of terms that they're not even very familiar with and what dates they'll be taught. And that doesn't really give them a clear picture of what you think is important, what you as the instructor think is important. It just gives them a list of topics. And so it's maybe unclear to the student what to focus on. The list of learning objectives allows a student to focus in maybe on a class-by-class basis. So there might be a larger scale goal for a week that's communicated clearly, and then a whole series of more specific objectives. And the student then knows very clearly what the instructor is hoping to accomplish during that time frame. Sometimes when students approach a topic for a class, they might just be thinking, I've got to memorize everything that the person's saying in front of me. Whatever's being told to me, I just got to memorize it. And I think learning objective helps alleviate that feeling of needing to memorize, because it often will communicate that the student has to do something more than memorize. So the student has to think about how things relate to each other, or be able to explain it to a non-scientist or something like that. And so it gives the student a perspective of what they're doing. Why am I here? Why am I being asked to do these kinds of tasks? Because I know that it all fits together into a bigger picture.
Often in a department, faculty are too busy to talk to each other about how their different courses align to one another. When departments develop a set of learning goals across their major, for example, that helps individual faculty know what direction to put their course towards. And then, in turn, that could lead to a better alignment of all the courses across the major.